Hello and welcome or welcome back to my channel. Please do like and subscribe if you haven't already. And today is new moon. So new moon today, we are going to do a Celtic cross to see where your energy is, what situation you've got going on currently at this new moon. This may help you to set an intention over this next couple of weeks. It's going to tell you about where your current situation is, any challenges, things that we need to let go of, what your strengths are, what to focus on, what's happening in your environment at this time as well. I'm trying to sit back as far as I can so you can see the cards. Okay, so we have the runes as well. So I've picked the cards already. So I've kind of got an idea of the energy that we're working with today, and we will pick the runes to go with that as well, just to complement them. So let's get into it and see where we're at, shall we? So first of all, there are a few that came out in the reverse position. Now that's not always a bad thing. Sometimes that can actually be a good thing depending on the card that we get. And the first card was the Two of Pentacles in reverse. Now when this is the right way up, so this is your current situation. When it's in the right way position, this talks about balance and flexibility and like being able to juggle things. So in the reverse position, this is kind of like a time where things feel a bit out of balance. There's perhaps a little bit of disharmony going on, feeling like you're juggling too many things or putting your energy into too many things. And it's just getting to a point now where it's like, I don't think I can maintain this anymore. There's a real feeling of something needs to give. And it's almost like, this is the summary really of this reading, is like it feels that something needs to give in your life that's connected to this situation. And once you do let go of that, it's actually going to allow you this real determination and drive and power to go towards things that you're passionate about, that really do fill you with love, joy, gladness, that kind of thing. So that's why the Two of Pentacles is here. Your current situation, there's a need for balance. Something is out of balance currently. So I'm going to pick a rune to go with that. See what is out of balance for you right now, your current situation. Okay, so it's something about what you want to intend, what you're intending on, what you want to manifest. It's interesting because your challenge card is the Sun in reverse, and this is the rune that connects with the Sun. So to have this with the Two of Pentacles in reverse is kind of telling me about there is still a need within you of healing. You're healing from something. And there's an intention that you have, but you feel a struggle to go towards that intention at this time because you feel like you're juggling so many other things. There's other things in the way that are kind of holding you back from that, and it's creating a disharmony. I do feel a little bit of frustration around this for many of you. So Sir Willow is here to help you with that healing journey. It's to help you to sort of maybe take a little bit of time to relax. It's asking you to sort of take a bit of time out. Maybe if you can just spend a little bit of time away from the things that you feel you need to head towards or go towards, because at the end of the day, if something is really for you, it will still be there, won't it, at the end, you know. Nothing is by accident and everything happens in divine timing. So there's no rush with this. Whatever it is that's this situation is that's happening for you at this time, maybe trying to juggle too many things and do too many things. Maybe at this new moon, it's helping you to realise what needs to give in order for you to, one, heal, and to really set that intention for what it is that you want to go towards. Okay, so we're looking at the Sun card in the reverse position again. So again, this would be about manifesting your dreams. You know, really bringing things into fruition that you've been looking forward to, that you've been wanting. But as it's in the reverse position, it's a lot to do with self-doubt. There's a lot of fear around this. There's a need for you to feel inspired, and you're just not really feeling very inspired right now about this particular situation and about your way forward in this particular situation. And it's kind of creating a lack of confidence in you to go towards it, to move forwards. So I'm going to pick a rune that goes with that now. So So what is the rune that represents the challenge that you're going through at this time? Okay, so the challenge is that perhaps there's been an element of illusion. There's something that feels elusive maybe to you, or there's a fear that, am I making this all up? Is this all in my head? Is this actually real, or have I just dreamt it? So Dagaz is kind of here to break through that illusion and to show you that actually, no, this isn't something you've made up. So you can stop doubting. You can start to feel more confident about it, because the rest of your reading is actually about you finding the confidence, the determination, the power and the drive to move forward with your intention. So whatever it is with Sir Willow as your overall reading, there is an intention that you have, but you're not able to fulfill it at this time because of lack of confidence, and your self-esteem is quite low. Maybe you're doubting yourself and juggling too many things is what I'm feeling on there. I don't know why I've just itched my leg so badly. It's almost like there's an irritation, and that was on my left leg as well. So I do feel that there's an irritation around maybe opening up emotionally as well. So Dagaz is kind of like the window to illuminating what is actually going on and breaking through those illusions. So it's time to break through those illusions now and really see clearly the way forward. Stop doubting yourself and find the confidence to drive it forwards. Okay. So we're going to move into your focus. What are we focusing on? And this is a beautiful card. We've got the Queen of Wands. Now, she is really powerful. This is a very passionate queen. She holds a lot of drive, determination and power. And I mean, this card comes out whether you're male or female. There's no gender with this, but it is about an energy of drive, determination and power. But it also represents the ability to be able to help others. And I do feel for some of you, this could be a time for really sort of embracing what's around you. Where can I put myself forward to help somebody else at this time? It's going to help you to express yourself, because this is what the Queen of Wands is all about. It's about boldly expressing herself. Yeah, she don't care what anybody thinks of her. She's really happy in herself. This is the energy that you could embody yourself, but you are holding back from allowing yourself to really be seen. And so they're asking you to make this your focus right now, is to find that passion that's within you. Be determined. Find your personal power through elevating your confidence. And to do that, it does feel to me like it's about reaching out to people and offering yourself as to be helpful. Offering some form of help towards people in your life is, I think, going to surprise you just how much you have to give, because there's a feeling of that you don't feel like you do have much to give, but you have a lot more than you realise. So what rune goes with the Queen of Wands today? Yera. Okay. So it might be slow process for you. It may be a slow burn, if you like. But you are coming round to the fact that you have moved through a lot of cycles of growth. Even over the past few months, you've gone through many cycles of growth. You've really found a new way with yourself. And you, I feel like, have completed a cycle recently that's kind of allowed you to see another way forward. But you need to find that passion and confidence to be able to be determined enough to go for it. There's something coming up in this, I'm feeling, about what other people think, being worried about what other people think of you in striving towards what it is that resonates with you, that you're passionate about and that you want. So right now you need to understand that your focus shouldn't be about what other people think and how they're going to respond to you. It's more about you expressing yourself from a place of confidence and realization of what it is that you need and you want. You've been through so many different cycles, you've collapsed so many different cycles that don't serve you anymore. How many more cycles are you going to go through on the same path, knowing it's not going to fulfill you, knowing it leads to this self-doubt? this is a time for raising your confidence to a point where it's like, I know what I need to do and the way forward for me. But it's going to take that little bit of confidence and stop doubting yourself, basically. So that is what we are focusing on at this time. Now, this card is interesting as, because we've got the Five of Swords, which is not the greatest card, to be honest, in the upright position, but we got it in the reverse position. And this is the area of what you're leaving behind. So actually, there's an element of, from the past, I feel maybe some resentment, some guilt. Something kind of broke your confidence from the past a little bit here. Maybe distorted your passion or the need for finding something to be passionate about. And this is about building your confidence, but from a place of fairness. So it's like, maybe if in the past you've had strategies and things that were for your own gain, this is about now, actually, where can I find balance in giving and receiving? That's what I'm getting from this. And that's kind of been the suggestion around here as well, hasn't it? Of sort of making sure that you know, what can I give, basically? What can I give here? Because it's going to help you to heal these wounds from the past. So, yeah, letting go of basically things that are getting in the way of you feeling peaceful. Let's see what room we have that goes with that. What is the room for the past? Perfect. I was is that rune of death and rebirth. And before, I have told you that this is connected to the yew tree, which is a poisonous tree. So it's almost like letting go of toxic things, things that have been toxic in your life. And when I say I don't like the word toxic, if I'm honest, but almost, you know, things that have maybe triggered you, held you back, kept you in patterns that you perhaps found familiar, but actually aren't really serving your highest timeline. They're not really helping you to grow, which is what we've got down here in your focus. You know, you have this need to grow. You've decided, I don't want to settle for comfort. I want growth. Whereas before, you may have settled for comfort and realised, actually, this isn't resonating with me because I'm getting this calling, I'm getting this pull that's trying to drive me forward. It's almost like your spirit guides are going, enough now with playing small, enough now with the self-doubt, you need to move forward. I'm going to talk about that over here in a minute, because in your future, there's something about that on the spiritual side of things that's really coming through quite strong. So this is what you're leaving behind in the past, is the debris from all of the things that you've been through, which aren't unnecessary. They were all necessary for your natural cycles of growth. But now it is time to take what you can from those lessons and move forward without the baggage. Okay, because you don't need to take that with you. And what you're moving here with your strengths is the Chariot. That's a very, very strong card to have for strength, because the Chariot is all about taking those reins, powering on, determination, and it was in the upright position as well. So it's basically saying to you, Spirit is saying, get on it. You've got the strength to get through this. You've got the strength to do it. What you want to manifest, you can. This is what's in your willpower. You are in control of those horses. You're in control of that carriage. Okay. Even if you don't feel you can control anything else, you can control what your willpower is looking for, what you want. Nobody else can control that. So let's see what room we have that goes with the Chariot. Okay. We have Athala. So strength in numbers is what's coming up in here. Now, Athala represents family. It's inherit gifts that we have from our ancestors. I do feel, again, working with the Queen of Wands down here and Yera, it's kind of that energy of, I do feel you needing to become more of a part of the community. So it's almost like bringing your gifts to other people and helping them. You've been holding that back for a little while now, maybe through fear of not knowing what you're doing, or that people are going to laugh at you or not really understand you. But this feels like a time where you are starting to embrace the way forward. And there's something about that that comes up here as well, actually, about maybe a new career path or a new way forward for you. But it starts with you kind of building this community around you. So this could be blood relatives, but it could be friends, or just people that you're really close with or want to be close with. And the Chariot is kind of calling you to drive yourself closer to these people, to these energies that are going to help you to get onto this determination, find the success, you know, utilize your willpower to drive this forward, because you do have the ability to drive this forward. There's enough of this self-doubt now, and hopefully through watching this video, if this resonates with you and you understand what I'm saying about that self-doubt and holding back, and maybe like, oh well, I'll maybe look into that tomorrow, and then there's distractions that happen and you never actually get to do it, and then you find yourself in your usual mundane things, feeling like, you know, daydreaming about the life you actually want to live and the way that you want to live, you know, but you are going through, I do definitely feel that you are starting to let go of these traits. You're letting go of these patterns from the past that have been a little bit toxic and kind of holding you in a place of guilt and resentment. You know, it's like constantly flogging yourself every day isn't good for you. You need to pull yourself out of that, find the confidence to move forward. But that starts with asking for help maybe, but also offering your services too. So it's like a balance then, give and take. And I do feel there's something there with maybe you are driven to go towards something. There's something that's driving you towards it, but there's a fear there. There's a self-doubt and a lack of confidence in how that's going to go is what I'm feeling from this. So now we have what's in your future, and in your future is very promising. This is the High Priestess, and the High Priestess is a very intuitive card. So this is, you know, really opening up your intuitive side. So I do feel a lot of reason why you're watching tarot readings and things is because you're getting a pull. You are feeling something is driving you forward. There's a calling within you, and I do feel it is on a spiritual sense that's kind of asking you to seek guidance at this time. It's asking you to seek guidance. Maybe that's why you are watching these videos, and it's trying to bring you to a place of serendipity. Okay, it's trying to bring you to that. So like letting go of this is going to bring you peace, and then into your future is a place of like having those spiritual experiences. I do see somebody that is starting to be a bit more determined with things like meditation, maybe yoga, practices that help you to access your spiritual side. I do see you doing something on a psychic level, maybe going to psychic development courses or something, wanting to know more. Maybe you're learning more about tarot. Maybe you're starting to work with tarot cards or work with runes even. Or anything like that, you know, trying to open up your skills. I can help you with that, by the way, if you do want to discuss that on a further level. Maybe drop a little emoji or something into the comments and we can discuss that further, or just drop me an email, get in touch. Now, there is a real need within you for peace. And what I'm getting from what's going on here at the moment is there's just so much going on, so many different threads around you. And a lot of them you have already admitted to yourself, I believe, that they're not necessary anymore. You're not doing this anymore. It feels maybe a bit empty. It doesn't fulfill you like it did. And you're kind of asking yourself, like, why am I keeping this in my life? Why am I doing this? Why am I doing that? Why do I need to do this? You know, whereas now this is more, you kind of found a depth within yourself that I don't think you felt before. And it's awoken you to something new. Maybe you've started speaking to God recently, or you found a new deity, a goddess, a Celtic goddess or something. But it's got a real strong spiritual calling for you in your future. And I do see you working with spirit as part of your future. Maybe you will become a reader yourself. or some kind of spiritual counselling. I'm going to get a rune to go with that. You may have been having a lot of dreams lately as well, or you will be in your future. Your dreams may become quite prophetic and give you information and advice. Yeah, okay. So TWAS is all about the self becoming higher. So it's almost like reaching up to your highest conscience. And I do feel for many of you, if you can let go of this stuff from the past, remove the self-doubt and start working on your confidence, it's going to awaken you so much to that connection with your higher self. And you are allowing yourself then in your near future to be really guided by what your spirit guides are guiding you towards. I do feel for some of you, you've already started to surrender to that. You've already decided, like, I'm feeling this calling. I'm feeling drawn to this. I'm feeling led towards this. And I'm actually going to allow myself to go for it because it feels right. It does feel right. Now, sometimes when we feel guided by spirit, it can feel like you've got to let go of things that maybe it does feel sad to let go of. It feels upsetting to let go of. But when you realise, like, there was a reason for that, there is a reason for this. It doesn't always make sense at the time, and it most definitely doesn't make sense to the people around you if they're still on the lower level kind of thing. They're on a lower vibration, basically. When you're resonating more with your higher conscience, you're elevating your vibration. And what happens there is you start to vibrate at a different level, and you will connect with people that are vibrating at that level. And the ones that are vibrating at a lower level kind of can't match your energy. And so you start to find that there's a disharmony with the communication with those kind of people, or they're just doesn't seem too relatable anymore. So it's unfortunate in a sense, but when you lose those connections, you actually start to realize you are allowing that person to grow in their own way as well. And you start to grow in your own way, you know, and you may form friendships and things maybe later on down the line if they start to, you know, vibrate at your level, but not always necessarily, but you will bring in people who are vibrating at that level, and you'll resonate with them. And sometimes you get to a point where you're like, wow, there's actually somebody that really understands me and understands, you know, what I've been feeling and thinking all this time, but I've been holding it in, suppressing it because fear of people laughing at me that are around me or not understanding me, you know, or looking at me like I've gone mad, that kind of thing. So we've got TWAS on there. Bear with me a second. Felt like I was spitting feathers. So that's what we're looking at in your future. So hopefully that brings you some good news, something exciting, something fortunate for you, because I do feel it is a promising future. You've got a lot going for you on there. You've just got to watch this self-doubt and try and move forward from there. Your advice is an interesting card because this is the Knight of Cups. Now, this is the most romantic knight. And it was a message here. Your advice was about, you know, don't be afraid to romanticize your life right now. Okay. Be wild in what your thoughts are as to your way forward at this time. Don't be afraid to think outside of the box. This is allowing you to really understand what is my passionate drive. What is the most passionate and creative drive that I have here? And this is somebody exploring maybe their artistic talents. So if there's something in there, and when I say artistic, I don't mean just like painting or drawing. It could be singing, it could be drumming, it could be dancing. It could be creating your own YouTube channel, that kind of thing, which does kind of tie into this here, because in your environment is kind of like a bit of a change being seen coming out. And I do feel that for many of you, you're starting to feel that energy of, I need to be more out in the limelight, I need to be seen here. And this energy is kind of like, you know, kicking you forward almost. And this is where you're like, oh, but I don't know, am I just making this up, am I just imagining it? Well, no, it's in there. Don't doubt it. So the Knight of Cups is kind of, you know, somebody that is in love with the idea of falling in love. somebody that is got that old romantic like chivalry about them. So this is a time for you really romanticizing your life at this time. You know, what are your passions? What are your artistic qualities? And let's see what rune we have to go with that. It may also signify, like, you know, go on that date if there's some, you know, if you are interested in making new connections in love or something. Maybe allow yourself to be wooed, or go and woo that person, or, you know, with that being in your advice, that's not a bad card to have. We have Lagos, which again, it's quite interesting because the Knight of Cups is a water energy, and so is Lagos. So this is when you open up to that romance, to that passion, and allowing it to just be open, Lagos will allow that flow of energy to intervene where it needs to go. There's movement with it. It's kind of like allowing you to bypass fear and just go with it. Just go with the flow, okay? And flow it will. It will flow, flow, flow. Now, this has a psychic energy to it, especially connected to dreams, same as the High Priestess. So if you aren't already, please do pay attention to your dreams. Now, if you're going to turn around and say, I don't dream, well, yeah, you do, but you may need to sort of try and call upon yourself before you go to sleep at night. Try and ask for your dreams to be memorable so that you can remember, and just really try and allow yourself to remember those dreams. There may be some subliminal videos and things that you can watch on YouTube that can help you to remember your dreams, okay? I always find sometimes keeping a notepad by the side of your bed, so, or use your phone notes or something. When you do wake up in the middle of the night after having a dream, write it down. It probably won't make any sense the next morning, but just try it, because it will actually help you to remember your dreams as you do that. Because you're kind of, you know, setting that seed of like, this is what I'm trying to do. So they will become more memorable to you. So this is your advice, is, you know, really allow your passionate, romantic side to flow at this time. It's going to benefit you greatly. So this moves us into your environment right now. Your environment is like, you're on in the spotlight. Yeah, the Six of Wands is just about somebody in their leadership, okay? Somebody that really knows what they're doing and is being seen for doing it. So there's victory here. It does resonate with, so your environment here, if you can allow yourself to get over the self-doubt, stop holding yourself back, find that confidence, because there's a lot of energy around this of being optimistic. So in your environment right now, be optimistic. Don't fear what might not happen, or am I making this up? Is this not really real and I'm just imagining it? No, you aren't just imagining it. This is real. This is what's happening. And you are being called upon to be seen, to come out into the light right now. Have you seen a lot of pheasants lately? I'm guessing you may have seen a lot of pheasants, because pheasants may represent this for you, especially if they're jumping out in the road to you as well. So if that hasn't happened to you already, then watch out for that tomorrow or the next day, because I do feel that there is some kind of sign there for you about this being seen. Yeah, so I'm going to just get a rune to go with that on there. Algiers, okay, so there is a need at this time for, in your environment, yes, a need to be seen, and yes, there is a need for maybe placing some boundaries though as well, and like just protecting yourself a little bit, because when we're in the limelight like this, there may be an energy of when you are seen, people can take advantage of that, or, you know, be sort of like destructive about it. So that may be a little bit of where your self-doubt is coming from, maybe where you've tried to strive forward before you've been rejected, or you've had an issue with that. But this is kind of asking you to just trust and know that you are protected. There is definitely a protection around you at this time that's kind of like, you know, we've got you, we're holding the space for you, you go out. It's a bit like, say, like a starlet, and the mom is in the background, or the dad or whatever, is behind the scenes, kind of like waiting there. And if anybody was to chuck, I don't know, a cup of piss or something at that person, that mother would fly out there, and that person, you know, their life just wouldn't be worth living, would it? That's kind of the energy that's coming from this. It's sort of like, you are protected. Don't worry about anybody throwing mud at you, or, you know, being funny with you or anything like that, because that'll get dealt with. Don't worry about it. You don't need to worry about that. All you need to worry about is, well, not even worry, all you need to be bothered about is driving that passionate energy forward so that other people can see that light, see your light. Because you've got an energy at the moment that you're kind of like, you're not really fulfilling and embracing all that you can be. You're hiding yourself away. And it's a shame, because I do feel from looking at this, you've got some real gifts. You've got a lot of runes and cards in here that are suggesting about a real high intuition, a real psychic energy about you. And some of the things in your life are a little bit chaotic, or a little bit old patterns that are kind of keeping your vibration low. So by detaching from those, it's allowing you to elevate more into the higher vibration, and you are going to resonate with other people on that vibration. So you're not going to lose out. You know, you don't need to cling on to people because you want them in your life. It is okay to let them go. And if money is a fear around this, don't be worried about it, that either, because you don't need anybody else's influence in your life to achieve that. That's what spirit want me to tell you. It's okay to move away from things that you feel are keeping you financially stable. You can find that financial stability for yourself. You are very, very protected around this, and you are being asked and called upon to step into that limelight right now. Your environment, you need to be seen, is what they're saying. Very interesting. Hopes and fears. Now we've got the Seven of Wands, which is interesting because we've got the Six of Wands in your environment, and then the Seven of Wands in your hopes and fears. Now the Seven of Wands does usually have quite a defensive energy about it normally. So I feel somebody that is feeling quite vulnerable about opening up here and allowing yourself to be seen at this time. This is being asked to share some ideas, share some information here. You're being asked to do that. Because this card also represents somebody that is really working on themselves for movement and growth. And I do feel that maybe you, part of your hopes are the ability to bring more of that out in yourself. I do see somebody daydreaming a little bit about the future, as working out serendipitously, peacefully, working with energy, working with spirit, as being your lifestyle, is what I'm getting from this. It's what you want. And there is their solar plexus. Can you see that like glowing out here? This is the seat of your power. And this is where we want to drive your, allow your confidence to really shine out, because I think naturally you are a confident person. But now is a time to really show just how confident you can be and not let it waver. You can trust in this. You can believe in this. I'm going to grab a rune that goes with that. The Seven of Wands, your hopes and your fears. got answers on here. So there is a need for communication. I do feel for many of you, there is somebody that you perhaps need to communicate these ideas with, your thoughts, your feelings, things that are going on in quite a vulnerable way. You need to allow your guard to drop a little bit and allow that vulnerability to show. Now, this could actually come from a place of you maybe opening up a space to allow that person to be vulnerable with you first, because that might actually help you to then trust in being able to open up vulnerably, that's what I'm going to say for now, to this person or to these people that are in your life. Because you're ready now. You are ready to be seen now. You're ready to open up here. You're ready to move forward in this direction because it just feels right. Intuitively, you're getting these downloads that this is right. This is the right way for you to go. And by doing this, it's opening your throat chakra. It's opening that amount of communication. It's about speaking your truth and being in the moment. And that's powerful energy for you to help raise your confidence. You know, and like I say, some people, they're not going to recognize you. They're not going to understand why you're doing this or what you're doing or how you're developing, you know, the cycles of natural growth that you've been through. They haven't been through, and they might not be coming with you on this journey. And that may be difficult for you to realize and to understand. But ultimately, it doesn't mean that they're going to be cut off from your life completely. It may just mean that you don't spend as much time with that person, or you stand in your power, you get your voice back from that person or people, to the point where it's like, I don't have to hide this anymore. Like, for instance, you know, when I was a lot younger, all my witchy stuff, all of this stuff, all my, you know, altar and everything that I did, I kept it all in a cupboard. And I got it out when I was on my own, when I had my time. Because the people that I was around, I didn't feel like I could explain it to them or show it to them for fear of them, I don't know, mocking it or, you know, taking something away from it, making me feel like it's not that important, but it was really important to me. And I feel like maybe some of you here watching this, maybe that's how you're feeling, is that you're hiding a part of your life. You are keeping it in a box somewhere. And maybe you're even pretending that you don't care about it in front of other people. Maybe you're actually actively saying that, like, I don't really, you know, it doesn't matter to me, this stuff. But actually, it really does. So when we do that, we're not being true to ourselves. And that can lower your confidence. It can make you really doubt yourself because you're actually... you're lying to yourself about what this means to you. And this is your opportunity now to allow yourself to grow into this. You know, romanticize your life. Allow yourself to be who you need to be and who you want to be without fear of anybody else knocking that down. And I tell you, the day that I could take my stuff out of my cupboard and put it out where I wanted it to be and actually found people could come round to my home or whatever and see all of that. To be honest, if they didn't like it, they just didn't need to come around again, did they? At the end of the day. So you start to learn your self-worth and learn that actually, you know, anything that's meant for me will resonate with me and will be with me. Anything that isn't, you know, I benevolently detach from. And I'm quite, you know, happy to say, move forward with your life. Deeply have love and respect for you, but we can't move on any further than this. Okay. So there doesn't have to be any like ill will or bad feelings or anything around that. It's just sometimes you don't resonate with people in the same way that you used to. And that's okay. So let's move it around then now onto your outcome. Because this is quite interesting. We've got the moon as your outcome, which we are in the moon at the moment, but that's a full moon. We're actually in the new moon right now. So the outcome is about trust in your intuition. So it's interesting because the reading began with things being out of balance, self-doubt, not trusting in yourself, disharmony. And the outcome is saying, just trust. trust your intuition, trust that you know what you need. And I do feel for many of you, you do know what this is, but you're not admitting it to yourself for fear, through fear, fear of what that means. So this is about, it's asking you to face your fears. The outcome is you facing your fears. And also, again, I'll bring it back to, we've got Lagos down there, about listening to your dreams. There's something in your dreams that is trying to get a message to you. Okay, so really listen to your dreams. Let's see what rune goes with the moon on here as well. I don't know why I was going to howl then for some reason, but I didn't, so you're lucky tonight. Okay, we have manas. At least it was then. We've got manas. This is awareness. This is also about legacy. So it can be things that we, the gifts that we have, bringing them forward to the world. I do feel for many of you, you've got a mission here. You've got something that you need to do. So it's time to take the mask off and allow yourself to truly be seen in your full illumination, your full light, because you've been holding back so much, going over the same patterns and things, almost like just putting a plaster over something because you don't know how to deal with it. But now you have an opportunity and you are being guided and almost pushed by your spirit guides here to really open up to this and give it a chance. Face those fears. Trust your intuition. Allow yourself to be guided by what's in here, here and here. Okay. Manas basically means mankind, and it's a difficult rune in lots of ways, because how we feel about ourselves and what we actually put out to other people can be very different things. So manas is asking you to align yourself with what's actually within you. You know, the person that you are, the version of yourself that you strive to be, that you're becoming. And what's going to happen here is you will almost be released to you a new guide, a new spirit guide. And this guide is vibrating on this higher level, okay? And it's a very powerful guide that is like knocking at the door right now, wishing and hoping that you would let go of some of this stuff from the past. And they will walk through that door as soon as you do. As soon as you make that choice, that's what's going to happen. And you will feel it switch on. You'll start to align more. You'll start to feel really blessed and grateful for things. You may even start to notice your financial situation improving, your living situation improving, your relationships improving, all of these things, yeah? The types of quality of people that you're going to be around will improve. All of these things are going to happen because you chose to follow your intuition, to allow yourself to be guided and facing your fears and having fun with it, enjoying it, romanticizing it, okay? You are going to become a powerful creator of something here, and bringing your gifts forward is what's needed right now in the world. So that is your reading for tonight. Enjoy your new moon, and please do let me know how this reading resonated with you. If you would like to book in for a personalized reading, my details are down in the description box. I've also left down there a little note about donations. If you would like to donate to the channel, I'm eternally grateful, but there is no obligation. So, oh, and thank you to those that already have. What I would like to say is thank you to those that watch my videos, that spend time here with me. Please make yourselves known though by liking, subscribing and commenting, because it just helps me to know that what I'm providing here, what I'm doing here, is helping somebody and resonating with somebody. So I will speak to you all again very soon. Have a blessed evening.